Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operation Research. This is lecture number 2.4 in the transportation model. The topic is optimum solution for the transportation model. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed one problem on the optimization technique. And now, here we use another example to understand the methodology of calculating the optimum solution for the transportation model. Learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the transportation model. We take example 2.6 to find the optimum solution, optimum transportation cost of the problem between supplying from factory to the warehouse. The source point is factory with a capacity S1 equal to 7, S2 equal to 9 and S3 equal to 18, and the warehouse demand are D1 equal to 5, D2 equal to 8, D3 equal to 7 and D4 equal to 14. Before we begin the solution procedure, we check the balance of the problem horizontally. 8 plus 5 plus 8, 13 plus 7, 20 plus 14, 34. The demand is, total demand is 34, and here vertically 18 plus 9, 27 plus 7 equal to 34. The supply capacity is also 34. So, it is a balanced type of problem. Now, we calculate the basic feasible solution using the Weigel's approximation method, and the cost matrix is given here, and we have to find out in the Weigel's approximation method, we have to find out the difference between the lowest and the next lowest value in the row and the column. We take the first row. So, in the first row, the lowest cost value is 10, the next lowest value is 19, difference is 9. We take the second row, the lowest value is 30, the next lowest value is 40, the difference is 10. We take the third row, the lowest value is 8, the next lowest value is 20, the difference is 12. Then we take the column, vertical column, the lowest value is 19. And the next lowest value is 40, the difference is 21. In the second column, the lowest value is 8, the next lowest value is 30, the difference is 22. And the third column, the lowest value is 7, the next lowest value, lowest value is 40, the next lowest value is 50, the difference is 10. Then the fourth column, the lowest value is 10, the next lowest value is 20, the difference is 10. So, now, among the lowest values, the highest value is 22. So, first the 22 is entering here. For the 22, the second column, the demand requirement is 8. And among the three cells, the lowest cost value is C32 equal to 8, where the capacity is 18, supply capacity is 18. So, all the demands are satisfied. We set the X32 equal to 8, and here out of 18, the balance available is only 10. The next highest value is 21. Now, the 21 is entering. Now, the 21 is entering. Now, here D1, the first cell, the demand is 5, and among the three cells, lowest cost cell is 19, where the supply capacity is 7. So, all the demand is satisfied here. Now, the supply capacity is reduced to 2. So, X11 is set to 5. So, the demand is satisfied. Now, the two columns are deleted. The two columns are deleted. Now, we have to once again find the difference. There is no change in the value here, and we have to find the difference here, 40 and then 20, and then here it is 52. Now, the next value is 52. So, 52 is the difference now. So, highest difference. Now, here the demand supply capacity is 10. It is available only 10. And here the lowest cell value, these two columns are deleted and the lowest cell value is 20. So, we supply all the 10 here, whereas the demand equal to 14. So, we completely supplied. So, the balance equal to 4. And this column, this row is also deleted now, and we are left out only these two rows and the 4 cells are available now. The next value is, next difference is 50. This actually the 10 minus 60 equal to 50. 50 is the next difference. Now, this 50 is entering. Now, these two are the cells available. Lowest cost value is XC14 equal to 10, where the demand equal, where the supply capacity is 2. So, all the 2s are satisfied. This 4 is reduced to 2. Next value is 60. So, the 2 is supplied here. The balance will be 9. Next 10 will be entering, and this is the 7 is the demand capacity, supply demand requirement, and 7 supply capacity is 7. So this 7 is allotted here, x2 3 equal to 7. Now it is completely exhausted, all the supply capacities are exhausted, all the demands are satisfied, so the allocation is over. Now the allotment is x11 equal to 5, x14 equal to 2, x23 equal to 7, x24 equal to 2, x32 equal to 8, and x34 equal to 10. So all the demands are say exhausted, and the, all the demands are satisfied, all the supply capacities are exhausted. Now the transportation cost we have to calculate, C11 X11 plus C14 X14 plus C23 X23 plus C24 X24 plus C32 X32 plus C34 X34. Substitute numerical values, 19 into 5 plus 14 into 2 plus 40 into 7 plus 60 into 2 plus 8 into 8 plus 20 into 10 equal to rupees 779. So this is the first solution. Basic feasible solution. Now we have to check for optimality. Before that we have to check the number of allocations are equal to m plus n minus 1. There are 4 rows and 3 columns. Sorry, 3 rows and 4 columns. So m equal to 4 and n equal to 3. So 4 plus 3 minus 1 equal to 6 and are independent. They are not forming the closed loop. So the allotments are independent. They are not forming the closed loop. And we have to go for optimality test. So first we have to designate the row as a U1, U2, U3 and the column as V1, V2, V3 and write the cost matrix of the allotted cells. So these are all the green color cells are allotted cells and white color cells are unallotted cells. So cost matrix of the allotted cells, and we take V1 equal to 0. When we take V1 equal to 0, this is 19. So for 19, this U1 become 19. When U1 become 19, so for this, this is 10, so 19, V4 becomes minus 9. Now when V4 is minus 9, so this is 60 and U2 becomes 69, so 69 minus 9 equal to 60. When U2 equal to 69 and this is 40, so V3 becomes 29. When V3 is 29, this is 0, so sorry, V3 equal to 29. Now when U3 equal to 29 and V2 become 21. So solving numerically, we calculate the value. So we equate the value. So by equating the values in the green color cells, we calculate V1, V2, V3 and V1, U2, U3. Now we calculate the values in the white color cell, that is unallotted cells. So write the UV value of the unallotted cells. Now subtract the values of unallotted cells from the original cost matrix. So these are all the unallotted cells from the original cost matrix, 30 minus of minus 2 equal to 30 plus 2 and 50 minus of minus 10 equal to 50 plus 10, 70 minus 69, 30 minus 48, 40 minus 29 and 72 minus 0. And this is the cell evaluation matrix. So here all the values are positive excepting 30 minus 48 equal to 18. And this cell is giving negative value, so the original solution is not optimum. Now we have to iterate towards the optimum solution. For iteration, first you have to write the original cost matrix, the basic feasible solution. This is what the original solution. Now we have to mark the cell in which new allocation is to be made. That is cell with negative value in the cell evaluation matrix. So this is the cell evaluation matrix. So this negative value here, we have to make the new allocation. And starting from the marked cell, form a closed loop. So in the allotted cell. So this is the formation of the closed loop. So the corner of the loop should fall in the allotted cell. So here, starting from here, we draw horizontal line. It takes x24 and we draw the vertical line, it takes x34, then again horizontal line and then vertical line. So loop is closed. And then we make allocation here, we make plus 2 here, we make allocation here and we have to balance horizontally and vertically. When I make plus 2 here and here I have to subtract 2. So this is minus 2. When I take minus 2 here, here I have to put plus 2. When I take plus 2 here, here again it is minus 2. So it is horizontally and vertically satisfied. Conditions are satisfied. Now you write the value. Allotted new marked cell and balance horizontally vertically. Find the second feasible solution. Now this is x11 equal to 5. There is no change in the allocation. x14 equal to 2. There is no change in the allocation. So here there is new allocation. x22 equal to 2. And x23 equal to 7, there is no change in allocation. x24, now 2 minus 2 equal to 0, there is no allocation now. So allocation is removed. Then x32, 8 minus 2 equal to 6. So x32 becomes 6. x34, 10 plus 2 equal to 12. So this is the new allocation. Once again, you check the number of allocations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 allocations and they are independent. They are not forming the closed loop. So, the second feasible solution of transportation cost is 743. So, when you calculate C11, X11 plus C14, X14 plus C22, X22, C23, X23 plus C32, X32 plus C34, X34, the cost will be 743. Now, for the second feasible solution, we have to check for the optimality. And once again, we do the procedure. We write, designate the row as a U and the column as a V. Write the cost matrix of the allotted cell. So this is the cost matrix of allotted cell, and we take v1 equal to 0 and find the uv values and write the uv values for unallotted cells. So 19 and v1 equal to 0, u1 become 19, and here it is 10 minus 9. When this is minus 9, this becomes 29. 29 minus 9 equal to 29, and when this is 29 and this becomes minus V2 equal to minus 21, so it will become 8. So we calculate V1, V2, V3, V4, U1, U2, U3, U4 of the using the values of the allotted cells. Now we calculate the UV value of the unallotted cells. So minus 2, minus 10, 42, 20, 51 and 29. Now we calculate the cell evaluation matrix. So subtract the values of unallotted cells, that is the white cells, the values in the white cell from the original cost matrix. So 30 minus of minus 2 equal to 30 plus 2, 50 minus of minus 10 equal to 50 plus 10, 70 minus of minus 51, and here 60 minus 42, 40 minus 29 and 72 minus 20, and the cell evaluation matrix is positive, completely all the values are positive. So the cell evaluation matrix does not possess any negative value, so the solution is optimal. So first we calculate the basic feasible solution. Check for the optimality using the UV method. Check for the optimality, and if the condition is not satisfied, iterate towards the optimum solution using the UV method. Then you calculate the second feasible solution. Once again, you check. So we stop here. So the second solution is optimum. So we stop here. These are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find operation research book. You can use the book for your better understanding of the subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You can subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You contact me for any clarification on the subject through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. We'll meet again with another problem in the transportation model. Until then, bye-bye.